Yeah. 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 Yeah.
What's up, good people? This is Growth Not Perfection, and we're gonna have some fun today. So I know I've been preaching hard on the fitness, but this is really about that mental aspect of it all. If you're not subscribed to the page, please subscribe to the page. Please. I'm enjoying my loyal following, small, but very loyal following. So let's start this ride and let's get it. So I know you guys look at this face and you see all these gray hairs and you're like, ooh, he's such a wise guy. 27 years of life and I have it all figured out. We're gonna set a few ground rules before we get started. So rule number one to training your mental and starting that new routine or achieving that goal is to sacrifice first and foremost. If you aren't willing to sacrifice that time, the energy, the people, the foods, the things that you love, then you can't expect a reward at the end of it all. Rule number two is you will fail, but do not quit. One of my old coaches used to say, once you quit once, it gets easier and easier to do it again. And the older I get, it proves to be true. So you will fail, but do not quit. And rule number three is to choose yourself. If you tell yourself you're gonna do something, then do it. Be accountable to yourself. Hold your word to yourself. So tip number one is to examine your current state of mind. And what I mean by know your position is, what are your talents or what aren't you so talented at? What do you like and what do you dislike? What are your constraints or your limits in the situation? But have an overall idea of what your current position is. Most importantly, what's your consumption like? What are you reading? What are you listening to? What are you seeing? What are you eating? What are you letting affect you internally? Before we can purchase our new home, we have to know where we're currently at. So basically, what's in the bank? What have we stored up for this huge investment? Can't make a change if you don't know where to go. Ask yourself, how do I feel? And is it sustainable? And then ask yourself, if I change my consumption, would I see better results? Would I see a better me? So we've examined our current state of mind. We know exactly where we're at. We know the things that we want to change and we know the things that we want to stay consistent. So tip number two. Number two is to have a clear eye view. And what I mean by clear eye view is the more specific the goal is, then the better chance you'll have of seeing the results that you want to see. Don't confuse your goals. Ask yourself, is my new goal or daily habit meant to improve my financial health or my mental health, my health physically, improve my social interactions with people and help them be more significant? Is it faith-based? But be specific behind the goal that you have. I think in most people's opinion, you wouldn't put carpet in the kitchen. And in my opinion, you can't achieve a goal that's too vague. On to tip number three. New goals, new habits are an overall routine change. Houses are places that we normally see ourselves staying 10 or 15 plus years. So you're making a major purchase decision. You're making a lifestyle change. You're making a major investment in you. Which takes us back to rule number two. Whatever you do, don't quit. You're making a major lifestyle change, and with that lifestyle change, it's not gonna be easy. So you need to be easy on yourself. Take a little bit of a breather and then get back at it. So to use working out as an example, you wanna be consistent, but after 3 weeks, you kinda fall off on week four. There's nothing wrong with that. Who are you trying to impress besides yourself? So take week four off, but make sure you get back to it on week five. Ultimately, determination wins out. If you want it, you'll go get it. Stay locked in, I hope y'all are still with me. Tip number four. Tip number four is to start small because it's easier to motivate yourself to take that little bit of action. So when you get consistent taking that little bit of action, challenge yourself to do more. So if I'm walking 3 times a week this week, when I get comfortable doing that, let's increase it to 4 and see if I can be consistent doing that. And then from then on, it's brick by brick, knowing that slow and steady wins the race. If you want to read more, then read 3 or 5 pages while you're in the restroom. If you want to write more, then buy yourself a prompt book. Just like brushing your teeth in the morning, you want to aim for that same type of consistency and that same type of ease. And you want to build that habit slowly but surely to not even really thinking about it. It's just part of your lifestyle now. After a while, all these little small bricks start to add up and the house starts to take shape. Remember rule number three, if you say you're going to do something, then do it. If you can't commit to yourself, then who can you commit to? And now tip number five, and probably the most important of all of them, is to reflect. Did I put in my best effort? Why or why did I not? However you question yourself, you need to reflect. Look in that mirror and ask the tough questions. One method that I like to use, and I invite you guys to use it as well, is to just grade yourself. If I say I'm gonna work out 6 days a week for the next 4 weeks and I only work out 17, then I get a 70. Now that may seem a little harsh, but we're being honest with ourselves. And since we're being honest, D's get degrees, so embrace whatever changes or whatever gains, however minimal, adjust and keep it going. And we'll close that out with rule number one, you have to sacrifice. Whatever effort you put in is the results that you will get out of it. So in conclusion, yes, yes, I am wise beyond my years, I know, stop, please. On a serious note, I've had success in my life using these steps, and this YouTube channel is proof of that. GMP is all things self-improvement, and I hope these tips have added value to your life. And please reach out to me on Instagram, shoot me a DM, and I would love to have a deeper conversation and see if I can nudge you towards that growth that you're looking for. I mentioned my loyal following in the intro. If you want to join that loyal following, then please hit the subscribe button down below. If you love me, then please tell your friends about us. Please, please, please. And you know how it goes. Stay healthy, stay blessed, and we'll catch you next time on Growth Not Perfection.
And I heard him say, nothing's ever promised tomorrow today. From the shy like Tim, it's a harder way. So this is in the name of love, like Robert say. Before you ask me to go get a job today, can I at least get a raise on the minimum wage? And I know the government administers AIDS, so I guess we just pray like the minister say.